The IPFW men's basketball team finished a 2003 portion of their schedule by losing four games in a row all on the road. But that's 2003. Today is 2004. And the Mastodons hope to get the new year off to a good start by defeating Southeast Missouri State here at the Memorial Coliseum. Hi again, everybody. Happy New Year to you. I'm Mike Maas, joined as always on College 56 by Charlie Washington. And Charlie, IPFW is happy to be back home at the Memorial Coliseum.
Well, they're 2-2 and have been playing well. And hopefully we can keep the good streak going this afternoon against the Southeast Missouri State Indians.
Well, IPFW, though they've lost their last four games, they've had one outstanding individual, and that's junior David Simon, who over the last six games has averaged over 18 points and seven rebounds per contest.
Well, he's a big cog in the IPFW offense as well as defense. The Dons have to have that young man on the court to compete at any level, and certainly he has to have some help, and everybody has to step up right now.
One other factor, Southeast Missouri State, 6-4 overall, but 0-4 on the road. IPFW, 2-2 here at home. Quick outlook to the game, Charlie.
Well, we have to control the tempo, Mike. Our freshman point guard, Bo Bauer, has to control the tempo. Terry Collins has to get into the basketball game offensively, and the big guy has to be on the court and help us offensively as well as defensively.
It's IPFW and Southeast Missouri State getting ready to do battle here at the Memorial Coliseum. Just ahead, starting lineups and the opening tip right here on College 56 Sports.
You know, if she continues to spill product at a rate of 3 per hour, unit cost, say 60 cents, factor in breakage, downtime, lost sales, you're looking at $2,400 a month. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Happy New Year, everyone. Welcome to the Allen County War Memorial Coliseum. This is Mike Maas along with Charlie Washington getting ready to call the action in today's men's college basketball game featuring the Indians of Southeast Missouri State University and the IPFW Mastodons. IPFW 2-10 coming into this game. Southeast Missouri State, or SEMO as we may call it this afternoon, has a record of 6-4. And starting lineups are being introduced here to the crowd in attendance at the Coliseum. And for Southeast Missouri State, it looks like this. At one forward, Damon Garner. Garner is a 6'6 junior out of Fort Worth, Texas. At one guard, Mike Nelke. Nelke is a 6-foot junior transfer from Valparaiso University. Another guard, Norman Prather. Prather is a 6'3 junior out of Caruthersville, Missouri. At one forward will be Brandon Griffin, 6'8 senior out of Greensburg, Louisiana. And at the other forward will be Derek Winans, a 6'2 junior out of East Cape Girardeau, Illinois. Head coach, Gary Garner, in his seventh season at Southeast Missouri State. For the Mastodons of IPFW, at one guard will be Terry Collins, 6-foot junior out of Fort Wayne Snyder High School. At the other guard will be Bo Bauer, a 6'3 freshman from Walton, Indiana. At one forward will be Keon Henderson, a 6'5 senior from Gary, Indiana. And the other forward will be Jim Kesnick, 6'10 senior out of Pewaukee, Wisconsin. And starting at center, David Simon, a 6'10 junior from Vernon Hills, Illinois. The head coach of the Mastodons, Doug Knoll, in his fifth year at the helm. Charlie Washington, as we said in the opening, the Mastodons are happy to be at home where they've won two in a row.
And they're feeling comfortable, Mike, and they, you know, have a little rhythm going here. The big things, once again, David Simon has to be on the floor, just his presence alone. Sure, we love for him to be productive offensively and defensively, but he has to be on the court, just the threat. His offensive and defensive threat. Terry Collins has to score the basketball this evening. Bo Bauer has to control the tempo as well as score the basketball some. And Keon Henderson needs to bring that athleticism. And big guy Jim Kesnick has to step up, has some big shoes to fill. A lot of people out, so we need him on the court and being productive as well.
Our officials today, Bill Connor, Anthony May, and Brian Anslinger. It'll be Connor throwing the ball up. It's David Simon against Brandon Griffin. And we are underway. Mastodons get the opening tip. Bo Bauer, the freshman point guard. Terry Collins looking for Simon in the block. Simon double teamed. Inside feed to Henderson. Off the glass
nice.
And in. Nice bucket.
And that's the athleticism that Keon Henderson brings that you have to have, especially with Quentin Carruthers out.
Mastodons up 2-0. Griffin in the paint. Has it docked away by Kesnick. Nice defensive play by the senior from Pewaukee, Wisconsin. Here comes Bo Bauer. Terry Collins, streak shooter. Henderson wants to drive the lane, and he is fouled. Thought it might be a traveling call, but Brian Anslinger says no. Foul is going to be on Mike Nelke, his first team first.
I don't think the referee wanted to call that, but I think there had to be something. Once Keon took the extra step and a half, there had to be some type of a call.
Mastodons inbound it. A fresh 35. Kesnick for three, off the rim, no. Rebounded by Griffin, and here come the Indians on the run. Pop-up jumper, no good. Offensive putback by Griffin as he rebounds the Prather miss. And we're
David Simon that time, Mike, had a good position, but kind of missed time to jump. The ball bounced a little higher than he read off the rim. And the SEMO center got the rebound.
Ball thrown away, inside feed, Henderson. First turnover on IPFW. And we have our first substitution for SEMO, Brent Hale. He is a 6'3 junior out of Dexter, Missouri. And he has the basketball. Again, we're tied at two. Played nearly 2 minutes. Foul away from the ball. Looks like Henderson's going to pick up his first foul.
That time he got caught on the screen, and one of the most open players, if you're any young kids watching the basketball game, and coaches, the most open player in basketball is going to be that guy that sets the screen.
Off the inbounds pass. Shot is missed by Garner, rebounded by Simon. Here comes Terry Collins. A scary sight, Simon at the point guard's location.
So far early in the game.
Alley-oop pass intended for Simon over his outstretched hands. Turnover, Mastodons.
As I was about to say, at the outset of the game, Simon's about a step and a half further out on the court than he wants to be, particularly that when he was at the point guard position, way farther than he wanted to be.
Hale with the three-pointer. And SEMO has their first lead of the day.
At this level, Mike, you cannot give any shooter that wide open of a look. It's just like practice.
Bauer stops, pops, and gets the friendly bounce. Bauer in the score sheet with the deuce. It's 5-4. Southeast Missouri on top. Before any shot was taken, we've got a foul.
Big guy Kessler's got beat that time and didn't see anything better to do than to just give a little shove there.
First foul on Kesnick, second on IPFW. Simo to inbound it. Inside, Griffin with the layup. Griffin now with four, and it's a 7-4 Indian lead.
Right now, Mike, the tempo's okay, but too easy for the Indians. Tempo's fine, too easy, getting too easy looks.
Collins, watched by Nelke. Simon. Little 10-footer, way off the mark. Rebounded by Gonner. Just inside the arc, up and in with the deuce is Derek Winans. Southeast Missouri State on top 9-4 as we've played about 3.5 minutes. Bauer up top. Inside feed to Simon, give and go to Henderson. Cowens for three off the back of the iron, no good. Rebounded by Gonner, and here comes Simo on the run. Give and go, Winans for a three. Doug Noel calls a quick 30-second timeout. We'll take a break as well. 12-4, Southeast Missouri State leads. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Did you know IPFW has its very own pep band? The Stomp Band is looking for more members, and we want you to join. IPFW students even receive a credit for their participation. Perfection is not required, just enthusiasm and a desire to share your school spirit. Check out our website for more information. Don't just play, stomp.
Back at the Memorial Coliseum, Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you, and Charlie, Simo has come out on fire. They've hit five of their first seven shots on the floor.
Well, they're getting such good looks at the basket. They're seemingly doing, you know, running pack practice drills, getting such easy looks, getting the ball inside and then kicking it right back out for pretty open three-point shots.
Here comes Bo Bauer, watched by Wines. Kesnick thought about a three. Move it around. Cowens inside, dishes off to Kesnick. JK almost lost it. Eight in the shot clock. Bauer forces a shot up. No good. Simon with the putback. David Simon in the book now with his first 2 points of the game and a badly needed basket.
Very much needed basket. I'm a little out of sync, but hey, we'll take the 2 points and hopefully that can get us going.
Brett Hale to Nelke. Back to Hale. Little two-man game here on the perimeter. Give and go. Nice feed from Griffin to Hale. Hale's fouled. He'll shoot two. Foul's going to be on Keon Henderson. That's his second. Team third.
And right now, Mike, a lot of good basketball movement. The Indians are getting it down to turn their heads on defense, and we're getting out of sync and out of position, defensive position, and they're getting good looks and fouls.
First free throw by Hale is good. Brett, a 69% foul shooter coming into the game. Already has 4 points, and he's looking for number five. And he gets it. And we have a timeout on the floor. 15-17, that's what the scoreboard clock shows. Our score, Southeast Missouri State 14, IPFW 6. Let's take a break. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
You in there? What's up? The show's a 7. Whoa. Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
back at the Coliseum. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. And Charlie, at the first media timeout, the numbers look like this. Southeast Missouri State, 5-7 from the floor for 71%. 2-2 from three-point range for 100%. 2-2 at the foul line for 100%. IPFW, 3-7 from the floor for 43%. 0-2 from three-point range. They have yet to shoot a free throw. Rebounds favor SEMO 4-2. Tempo favors SEMO right now.
Yeah, right now they're making it look awful easy. They're running some basic movements and they're setting some picks. And the Dons are getting their heads turned and not moving when that ball's in the air on defense and getting out of defensive position.
Justin Hawkins in a lineup for Doug Knowles Mastodons. He has the basketball. Simon, who's hit double figure scoring in the last six games, kicks it out to Collins. Three-pointer, yes! Terry Collins hits his first shot of the day, and maybe that's a good omen, especially since it's a three ball. Nelke comes right back with the three for Southeast Missouri State.
Wow, and he was a little bit behind the arc that time.
Indians 3-for-3 from long range right now.
They're dialing it up.
Bauer with the basketball, penetrates. Gets it off to Dave Simon.
See, Mike, right there, that's too far out on the court that you want Simon. You don't want him there. You want him down deeper.
Eight in the shot clock. Kesnick to Bauer, four in the shot clock. Bauer drives, forces up a shot, no good. Griffin rebounds it. And here comes Southeast Missouri State. Goner to Nelke. Up top to Hale and move it around the perimeter. It's Griffin on the high post. Nelke, another three ball off the rim. No good. Kesnick with the rebound. First three ball missed by Southeast Missouri State. Hawkins with a baseline jumper wide of the mark. Griffin rebounds it. Back comes Southeast Missouri State. Goner fires a 10-footer. Yes, gets three bounces. Damon Garner gets his first points of the day.
Kind rim that time.
19-9 our score. Southeast Missouri State on top in front of a stunned crowd here at the Coliseum. So we're near the 13-minute mark. Terry Collins wants to drive, and he's fouled by Nelke before any shots taken. Mike Nelke picks up his second foul. Second team foul. A couple of substitutions for Southeast Missouri State. Adam Crater, number 44, is a 6'11 junior from Donovan, Missouri. And not sure if that kid is the only sub right now. Meanwhile, Collins kicks it up top to Hawkins. The Don's on the perimeter. Brandon Jennings in the lineup for the first time for IPFW. Shake and bake by Collins. He's cut off. Still plenty of time on the shot clock. Collins fakes a three, drives a lane, shot up, no good. Ball goes, well, there's a foul underneath. Ball went off of Jennings' hands. Crater picks up the foul, his first, as Kian Henderson returns to the Mastodon lineup.
And Mike, right now, David Simon has to realize how important he is to this basketball team. And he has to work harder inside and, give me that basketball. He has to work harder and demand that basketball inside deeper and get better defensive position. Offensive position, excuse me.
Pass knocked out of bounds. They'll try it again. 12:43 on the first half game clock. Bo Bauer to inbound it. Henderson, three ball off the back of the rim. Fight for the rebound, and they're going to call a foul on Brandon Jennings. As he and Wyans were doing battle. For Jennings, that's his first, team fourth. So here comes Southeast Missouri State. Tarek Willoughby, that's the other substitute I was thinking about. Number 12. Goner in the blocks. Crater forces it up, and he travels with the basketball. Good defense that time by Jennings, forcing Crater into a turnover. Brandon Griffin back in the SEMO lineup and making his first appearance today. DeMarcus Hintz, number 24, Hintz, 6'6 senior out of Memphis, Tennessee. And you see head coach Gary Garner going for win number 100 as the Indians head coach today. Henderson up top. Bauer to Simon in the block. Let's see what Dave does. Spin left. Left-hand shot knocked out of bounds by Hintz.
Just that initial nudge that Griffin's getting Simon out on the block allows that block shot right there. If he's that one step in when he catches the ball, the defense doesn't get to that or it's a foul.
Collins for three. Fort Wayne Snyder grad knocks down his second tray in a row.
Great shot. Wasn't in rhythm, but hey, once again, we'll take it.
Gunner for three. Damon Garner now has 5 points. And our score is 22-12. Indians on top. Jennings up top to Collins, around the horn to Henderson. Henderson being watched by Hintz. Has it taken away? Loose ball, Bauer's got it, and he throws it away. Garner's gonna probably jam it. No, he lays it up off the glass instead. Damon Garner now with 7 points. Poor ball handling by IPFW.
That's good hustle by Bo Bauer, and Jennings just wasn't looking for the basketball.
Simon backing in, tries to force it up over three players. And turnover, I believe, on IPFW. And we've got another timeout on the floor. 11-10 left until halftime. Our score, Southeast Missouri State 24, IPFW 12. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports. Look at some of the members in attendance here today. Don, the mascot. Charlie Washington, SEMO is not cooling off. They're actually getting hotter. They're now 9 of 12 for 75% from the floor. 4 of 5 from three-point range for 80%. It seems like they can literally do no wrong.
Well, they're getting it. They're getting the ball in the positions where they can make shots. And that's something that the Dons aren't doing right now. They're getting easy looks. There's not much resistance from the Don defense. And what we have to do on offense, get David Simon, I think he's out of the basketball game right now, but get an offensive threat down low. And right now we're just not doing that. Terry Collins hit some shots, but he's not in a rhythm. So the movement has to get a little crisper. Screens have to be a little harder. And we have to get some easier looks, break down this Indian defense.
IPFW has turned the ball over 5 times so far. And here comes Tarek Willoughby up the court for Southeast Missouri State. Hale, watched by Collins. The Don stretching the defense now a little bit. Griffin, give and go. Nice shot up and in by Hintz on a give and go from Brandon Griffin.
Once again, good crisp movement and the help is not there. Our defensive players on the ball are turning their heads and the help just isn't there as well.
Byron Malone, the freshman from Indianapolis North Central, in the lineup now. And Terry Collins is called for traveling. Turnover number 6. And that's one thing that IPFW wants to avoid is a high number of turnovers.
Yeah, that's the key, Mike, at any level of basketball. Once again, whether it's lunchtime basketball with the Lunch Bunch crew or whether you're playing in the NBA, turnovers will kill you. And points off turnovers.
On the year, IPFW is averaging nearly 16 turnovers a game. Griffin fires up a shot, no good, but he's fouled by Kyle Thrasher. It's Kyle's first. Team fifth. So Brandon Griffin at the line. misses the first.
Well, you have to hope that they'll cool off sooner or later, Mike. But with the looks they're getting, the six to point blank shots, even the three-point shots are wide open. I don't see it. You have to put some defensive pressure and make those shots tougher.
Griffin missed the second one as well. Jennings with the rebound. Dons dodged a bullet there. Now let's see if they can get into this 14-point deficit. 26-12 is our score as we near the 10-minute mark. Henderson for three, yes.
Great shot. Great shot. Great spot up that time by Keon Henderson. And he has, out there on the court right now, he has to provide some punch. A lot of pressure on Terry Collins right now. And Keon has to provide some offensive threat.
He now has 5 points. Your fellow brother from the region.
The region.
Griffin, watched by Thrasher. Kicks it out to Garner, fires a three. Wow. Simo, 5 of 6 from three-point range. Garner now with 10 points. Henderson fakes it, tries to find Thrasher. Kyle wasn't looking. Griffin picks it off. Here come the Indians. Griffin on the post. Indians move it around. Ball knocked away. Nice play by Kyle Thrasher. Forcing turnover number 4.
Really good post defense that time.
Thrasher for 3.
And ready to reward. Reward the defensive, great defensive play that time and a great look that time and a much needed basket.
First shot of the day by Kyle Thrasher is a 3-ball. Willoughby comes back and makes it a long 2. Tarek Willoughby now with 2 points.
And that was pretty good defense, and for the most part, a 4th shot, and they still knocked it down.
31-18, our score, 8.5 minutes left until halftime. Dons trailing by a baker's dozen. Collins, shake, bake, shot, up and in. Terry Collins now with 8 points.
It's a great creation by Terry Collins, creating his own space for an open opportunity.
Hale for 3. Brett Hale now 8 points as well, including 2 trays. Simo, unbelievable. 6 of 7 from three-point range.
They're playing like this is their home court, and they shoot on this court every day.
Henderson stops, pops short. Thrasher tries to save it, but Hale gets the pass instead. Willoughby, Garner. Shot missed by Hintz. Henderson with the rebound. As we near the 7.5 minute mark. Collins looking for Thrasher in the block. Watched by Brett Hale. Malone tries to create something. Shot no good, but Byron is fouled. And he'll go to the line to shoot 2.
Here we go.
Let's go. Very important right now, Mike, as the Dons head towards halftime to try to keep this single digits is what you want to look for. Single digits is a great mindset, momentum builder. If you can get there, that's not going to help miss free throws. But if you can get there by halftime, you're in a good mindset going into the second half, keeping it close. And on the other side, you're trying to expand that lead and take away that any momentum that the Dons might get.
Malone misses the first, a flood of substitutions. Simon, Hawkins, and Bauer in for IPFW. Winans back in the lineup for Southeast Missouri State. Second free throw, no good, so Malone misses 2 after Griffin had missed 2 on the other end for Southeast Missouri State. Willoughby, watched by Malone. Kicks it in the corner. Winans. Prather. Give and go. Bauer with the steal.
Good defense.
Bo Bauer to Hawkins. Shot blocked by Willoughby. They're going to call a jump ball. And on the alternate possession, it'll be Southeast Missouri State. Timeout on the floor. 6:52 left in the half. 34-20 our score. Southeast Missouri State on top. gives us a chance to invite you to join Coach Doug Noh on College 56 for the Doug Noh Show. Highlights and perspective from Coach Noh and his guests. Here's truly Mike Moss. We open up the show on Thursday evenings at 6:30 and Saturdays at noon. Again, that's the Doug Noh Show right here on College Cable Access Channel 56. Charlie, I don't know what to say. Southeast Missouri State, they come in here after a tough loss to the DePaul Blue Demons earlier in the week. They have not won a game on the road yet this year. They're 6-4 overall, but they're 5-0 at home, 0-4 on the road, and 1-0 on a neutral court. And like you said a moment ago, it seems like they feel this is their home court.
They're just flat out shooting the lights out right now, and they're doing, you know, everything, you know, that you can do. I wouldn't think that any team could play any better than they're playing right now. So what the Dons need to do, once again, get that lead under double digits, and you can go into halftime saying, hey, folks, these guys aren't going to play any better than they played this first half. And we're still only down, you know, let's say 7-8 points. We're right in the thick of this basketball game. But right now, they're doing everything right. They're forcing bad shots. They just blocked the shot. They forced Keon Henderson a moment ago into a bad shot, or actually wasn't a shot. He threw the basketball away. So right now, they're doing everything they want to do. And the Dons, last time, though, there was a very good defensive play by Bo Bauer to get his hand into the passing lane and disrupt some of that easy movement and those easy shots that the Indians have been getting.
Mastodons in a zone defense right now. Shot up and missed by Prather. Ball knocked out of bounds, and they're going to say last touch by IPFW. Nelke comes back in the lineup for Southeast Missouri State, replacing Hintz.
That an easy shot that time, but just the presence, the mere presence of David Simon down low caused that jump hook air ball right underneath the basket.
A little confusion at the table as to whether or not Mike Nelke had actually checked in the scorer's table. Now they get it right. So Nelke's in for Willoughby. So Nelkio inbound it. Connor, watched by Simon. Indians moving it on the perimeter. Six on the shot clock. Wyans gonna drive on Bauer, fires one up, no good. Fight for the rebound, controlled by Malone. Outduels Connor for it. Here come the Mastodons. Hawkins for three, in and out, no. Rebounded by Brandon Griffin for Southeast Missouri State.
That's a good look off the transition that time by Hawkins. Just didn't fall for him.
Prather, hop step and a jump, no good. Tap, no good. Griffin out fights, two downs for the ball. Prather on the return pass. Bauer fouls Griffin going up. And Griffin will go back to the line to shoot two.
Right now, Mike, they're getting the loose balls, they're getting the offensive rebounds, and they seem to be a step or a step and a half quicker than the Dons right now to every possession and every loose ball.
Brandon Griffin at the line for two. He's 0-for-2 today from the stripe. Yeah, that didn't work, Charlie. Couldn't keep the curse going. He knocks the first one down. He now has 5 points on the afternoon. Try to make the second. And he does. So Griffin hits two from the line. It's now 36-20 with 5:45 to go here in the first half. Dons. Bauer looking out. It's back up top to Malone. Now the Dons going to do some perimeter passing. Simon from 18 feet hits. Dave Simon now with 4 points.
That's a very good shot by Simon, who can extend his range out there, but I'd still rather see him down on the low block, working hard to get that basketball.
Wyans for three, in and out, no good. Hawkins with the rebound, outlets it to Malone. Malone scampers up the floor. Dons now on the offensive set. Bauer, turnaround jumper is good. So Bauer showing athleticism. He now has 4 points. It's 36-24, so we're under 5 minutes to go until halftime. Nelke. Moving inside and out. Garner, three ball, yes. Third three-point field goal for Damon Garner. He now has 13 points.
I wouldn't necessarily call him a pure shooter, but I tell you what, he's lining it up and knocking it down right now for the Indians.
Simon double-team, loses the ball. Knocked out of bounds. Off of Bauer. It'll be Simo basketball. Brett Hale back in the lineup, replacing Prather for Southeast Missouri State. And here comes Mike Nelke up the floor in a hurry. Pass knocked out of bounds, they say tipped and touched by IPFW. Oh, now the officials are conferring. And they're going to say it's Simo ball. Doesn't make the crowd very happy here, most of the crowd. Brett Hale with the ball. Nelke, watched by Malone, cross court pass. Nice give and go. And Thrasher hammers Garner before Damon Garner can put in the layup.
The Dons right now are in a, I think it's some type of a matchup zone. Looks to be a 1-3-1 matchup type of a zone. And the Indians are even picking that apart from the looks of it.
In all honesty, Charlie, I think the Dons are in the twilight zone right now as Garner knocks down the first.
This is a strange, you know, kind of a strange time. You know, your classes are out. You've been on break right now. This is it. No classes. This is it. Basketball is it. And that can work either way for you. You know, you're home, or you're practicing, but you don't have that rhythm of classes. So sometimes the classes gives you that rhythm, that consistency. This is a different time set for you. So the energy could help you, and it might even work against you.
Gunner makes the second. Makes it 41-24. Under 4 minutes to go. Kesnick and Collins back in the lineup for IPFW, and Kesnick has the ball knocked out of his hands by Garner, and Garner will pick up his first foul. It's fifth team foul on Simo. Willoughby back in the lineup. And we have a timeout on the floor. 3:51 left here in the first half. Our score, Southeast Missouri State 41, IPFW 24. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Where can you see the world famous writers, performers, musicians, and other artists up close and personal? Right here at IPFW. On the next edition of IPFW Up Close, we'll tell you about three very special series that take place at IPFW every year. You'll learn all about the Omnibus, Visiting Writers, and Plugster series. Join me, Jeanette Liu, as we learn the history of each event and how the guest artists are chosen. Watch IPFW Up Close Sundays at noon on College Cable Access Channel 56.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Memorial Coliseum. Again, Happy New Year to you. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. And Charlie, Southeast Missouri State, well, they're cooling off a little bit. They're now only 14 of 22 from the floor for 64%, 7 of 10 from three-point range for 70%, 6 of 8 at the foul line for 75%. They are led by Damon Garner with 15 points. 8 points from Brett Hale, 6 points from Brandon Griffin. Mastodons, 10 of 22 from the floor for 46%, 4 of 8 from long distance for 50%, 0 of 2 from the foul line. They are led by Terry Collins with 8 points, 5 points from Keon Henderson.
And they've at this point, Mike, they just haven't given the Indians much resistance at all, and that formula that the Dons have to win just hasn't been there.
Simon underneath forces a shot up, and it's the friendly roll. Dave Simon now with 6 points.
And that's one of the components of that formula that the Dons have to be successful to get him the basketball inside.
Hale watched by Collins. Griffin spin move off of Simon, no good. Collins at the rebound, IPFW on the run. Simon inside, spin move, has it shot knocked away, and he's fouled. Dave Simon to go to the line for two.
Right there, Simons got the basketball that time before the Indians had a chance to set their defense. He got the basketball and made his move before, because Griffin's doing a tremendous job pushing him out. People may not realize, watching the basketball game, how important a step or a half step away for a big man, how uncomfortable that may make him. And that's what's been happening to Simon. Griffin has been doing a great job pushing him out a step further than he wants to be to make his moves.
Dave Simon makes the first. He's only a 66% free throw shooter. Knocks down the second as well. The junior now has 8 points. The Dons now trail 41-28 as we near the 3:18 mark here in the first half. Willoughby looking for somebody, gets it to Brett Hale. Nice feed to Griffin to kick it out. Willoughby for three. Willoughby with his first three. Simo now 8 of 11 from long distance. 72%.
That was a matter of making the adjustment. The Dons made the defensive adjustment on the switches once the defense was broken down, and the Indians just made the extra pass and got the best shot available.
Terry Collins knocks down his third three of the game. He now has 11 points.
Now we need a couple of stops and scores. A couple of stops and scores.
Griffin hands it off to Winans, and Winans makes the bucket. Derek now has 7 points.
You're getting caught watching the basketball and not watching the ball as well as our man. Get down that peripheral vision, see them both. We're watching the ball, and as the ball goes to the center, to the top of the key, they're cutting.
Kesnick for three. And a nice feed.
Now we can't trade baskets, Mike. We have to have the stops this time. Great that we're starting to score now, but you can't trade baskets. Even if it's threes for twos, we need stops.
You're reading my mind, Charlie. 46-34 at the two-minute mark. Dons down by a dozen. Griffin driving on. Simon. Shot rolls around and in. Brandon Griffin now with 8 points. Collins. And hounded by Hale. Simon. Out the bucket. Simon's fouled. Willoughby picks up the foul.
I keep interrupting you there. David Simon gets the basketball, makes the quick move versus the couple of dribbles, makes the quick move before that help defense can get there, and also that half step to a step down deeper that he's already in if he gets good position.
Simon misses the free throw, but he gets the rebound, and the Dons will reload. 1:35 to go. Collins drives baseline. He's double teamed. Gets it back to Simon. Bauer for three off the rim. No. Rebounded by Goner. And Southeast Missouri State calls a 30-second timeout. We'll take one as well. 48-36 our score. Dons trail by 12. You're watching IBFW basketball on College of Music Sports.
Mom, Dad, you know we love kids, and I've made a decision that will totally change my life. Cameron's too. It's a huge responsibility, leading someone into, who knows, communication or science or math. That's what life's all about, right? Learning so you can pass on knowledge to younger minds. Dad, Mom, I want to be a teacher.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Welcome back to the Memorial Coliseum, everybody. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. 121 and counting left until halftime. Southeast Missouri State with a 12-point lead and the basketball. Tarek Willoughby to Brett Hale. Hale, long three-point shot is good. Hale has 3 3-point field goals here in the first half. And it's 51-36 as we're under a minute.
Once again, too easy.
Collins kicks it off. Simon bumped by Garner, I believe. Dave Simon will go to the line. Oh, they're going to call the foul on Griffin. That is Brandon's second, team eighth, as Adam Crater goes back in the lineup for Southeast Missouri. And Dave Simon is 2 of 3 at the stripe. This is a big front end of a 1-1, Charlie.
Yes, no question about that. The Dons, they're hanging tough. They're out of rhythm, and that's the big thing. The baskets they're getting are not truly within a rhythm, but they are, you know, they as of late, they've been working hard and getting some baskets to fall. And on the other end, the Indians are getting everything right into an easy, simple rhythm.
Simon made the first with a couple of bounces, made the second one cleanly. Dave now has 12 points.
A stop in the basket here is tremendous right now.
Ball knocked away by Bauer. They said he stepped on the end line. Good effort by Bo Bauer, the freshman from Lewis Cass High School. 25 on the shot clock, 38.5 on the first half game clock. Willoughby will inbound it. To Brett Hales, picked up by Terry Collins. Donner. Got a big first half. Lobs it to Crater. Back up top. Hale for three. This one he misses. Rebounded Simon. Outlets to Collins.
Now we need a bucket for momentum. A bucket for momentum, guys.
Collins cut off by Hale. Brings it back out. Shot clock's off. 14 seconds to go. Bauer. Watched by Wyans. Collins shaking big time. Forces it up. Nice feed. Kesnick off the glass and in. Nice feed. Collins to Kesnick. And Charlie, they got that last bucket. They trail going into the locker room, 51-40.
Not quite under the double digits, but it's a good momentum builder. Got a couple of buckets, and that last defensive stop, you got the rebound, and you go down and score. That's exactly what you want, other than getting it down underneath the double-digit points.
Again, it's halftime here at the Memorial Coliseum. Our score, Southeast Missouri State 51, IPFW 40. Indiana Purdue Fort Wayne presents Spotlight on IPFW, an up-close look at some of the hidden treasures on our campus. Our spotlight today is shining brightly on the IPFW Herb Center, directed by Professor Bruce Kingsbury.
This is something most people will never see.
This is a timber rattlesnake. This is our biggest poisonous snake, but it is also relatively uncommon and occurs in some of the forested hills of southern Indiana. This is a male, so this is the smallish male. They get quite a bit bigger than this.
Biology professor and herpetologist Bruce Kingsbury never outgrew his childhood love of creepy crawly things and has made the study of endangered reptiles and amphibians in the Midwest his career focus. That interest led him to want to start some sort of conservation center on campus. A discussion with Vice Chancellor for Academic Affairs Susan Hanna resulted in him submitting a proposal for what is now one of several centers of excellence at IPFW, the Center for Reptile and Amphibian Conservation and Management, otherwise known as the HERP Center. The mission of the HERP Center is to promote the conservation and understanding of reptiles and amphibians through research, education, and outreach.
We conduct a variety of research projects on species that are endangered at some level in the Midwest, and a lot of times what we're doing is finding out about their basic ecology, what their habitat needs are, how they move around, what sort of impacts there are in terms of human activity, and then we work with agencies such as the Fish and Wildlife Service or the Department of Natural Resources to try to figure out what might be done a little bit differently to help protect those animals.
The main focus of the HERP Center's research is on endangered reptiles of the Midwest. Studies have been conducted on many species of turtles, frogs, toads, salamanders, and snakes. Today, we're focusing on the snakes. We've already seen a timber rattlesnake, which is generally found in south-central Indiana in the Bloomington area. Now it's time for another species of rattlesnake, the eastern Massasauga, which is found in northern Indiana.
Massasauga lives in wetlands which are kind of mucky and hard to walk through, and not that many people go out in them. And they're also rare, and so we don't see them very often. Even those of us who study them struggle to find them. We have a, a bias that benefits us in terms of finding them, that we use radio telemetry to track them around. This not only allows us to find the same animal over and over again for years at a time, it also leads us to other individuals. With a snake, we definitely have some problems. There isn't much of a neck, and in fact, if you did put something on the outside of the snake, they would have trouble crawling around because they are reliant on their slender body form to get around the way they do. And because of that, we place the transmitters internally in the snake. We actually do a surgical operation, and the antenna runs up underneath the skin, and when we're done, you can't tell that the transmitter's in there.
In addition to doing research on endangered species, the Herp Center also does projects which involve GIS, or geographic information systems. GIS provides a computer-based, multi-layered picture of an area of interest, which allows an investigator to examine how different spatial features interact. As an example, here's an aerial photograph of a specific area. Another layer shows the different kinds of habitat at the site, and the final layer shows the location of animals found there. Kingsbury says having this information on the computer helps researchers figure out what's going on across the landscape. One of the things the center is asked to track is pollution.
There's different kinds of pollution. There's point source pollution, and there's point source pollution. And what we're helping these agencies with is methods for visualizing the non-point source pollution.
What is non-point source pollution?
That's pollution where you, like runoff from agricultural fields or something like that, where you don't have a pipe or something like that, where you can go there and say, yeah, this is where this pollutant is coming from. In fact, it's distributed across an entire watershed, and it's only by looking at the whole thing that you can actually see where the problem is.
The center also maintains a website at herpcenter.ipfw.edu, which is filled with educational and outreach information.
We as a public should care about wildlife and about doing what we can to protect it. And what, if we do the work to figure out how to protect things, we often find that it doesn't take that much of an effort on our part to protect these kinds of animals. Often it's just minor adjustments in terms of timing or in terms of land use, and that we can largely go about our business. A lot of people are afraid of snakes, and typically that's really unfounded. And it could be because of some experience that they had when they were younger. It could be because of some biblical implications of what snakes are or what they represent. And a lot of times it's because snakes are a little bit unpredictable and strange looking because they have no legs. And what is strange to us might also make us afraid. But most of the snakes, in fact, in terms of a count of snakes, I'd say almost all snakes are totally harmless, and that if anything, they might bite you if you pick them up. But even that would be, I'd rather get a snake bite than a scraped knee or something like that. And with regard to the poisonous snakes, what we have found and that what others have found as well is that these snakes are not aggressive, and in fact, unless you catch them out in the open, they'll do everything that they can to stay hidden. And you can stand next to them, you can step over them, you can even bump them, and they'll hold still and they'll just hope that you don't notice them. They're very intent on staying hidden, and they would rather just have you keep going the way you were going and not mess with you than vice versa.
And for Kingsbury, the best part will always be working with the creepy crawlies.
Are you in there? What's up? The show's a 7. Whoa.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Did you know IPFW has its very own pep band? The Stomp Band is looking for more members, and we want you to join. IPFW students even receive a credit for their participation. Perfection is not required, just enthusiasm and a desire to share your school spirit. Check out our website for more information. Don't just play, stomp.
Where can you see world-famous writers, performers, musicians, and other artists up close and personal? Right here at IPFW. On the next edition of IPFW Up Close, we'll tell you about three very special series that take place at IPFW every year. You'll learn all about the Omnibus, Visiting Writers, and Plugster series. Join me, Jeanette Liu, as we learn the history of each event and how the guest artists are chosen. Watch IPFW Up Close Sundays at noon on College Cable Access Channel 56.
Where it is halftime of our NCAA Division I men's basketball game featuring the Indians of Southeast Missouri State and the IPFW Mastodons. Mike Mosh, Charlie Washington with you. And Charlie, at the halftime intermission, Southeast Missouri State leads IPFW 51-40, and they've controlled this game almost from the opening tip.
Well, looking at, you know, as we look at the stat sheet, it's kind of, you know, the Dons really haven't played all that bad. Looking at the game, though, it's just been too easy for the Indians. They've gotten everything that they wanted to do, and they've nailed shots. They've not had a lot of turnovers. They've gotten to the free throw line. They've done just about everything that you'd want to do to win a basketball game. And not that the Dons have played that bad, but they've been out of rhythm, a little bit out of rhythm, a step further than they wanted to be out on the floor. On the post, a step out further, and that makes a lot of difference. And then on the other end of the court, the Indians haven't met much resistance at all in terms of doing whatever it is they've wanted to do, inside or outside, and they've shot the lights out from the three-point arc.
Well, those halftime stats, you had a good look at them on the screen. Again, Southeast Missouri State, 18 of 28 from the floor for 64%, 9 of 13 from three-point range, what you were alluding to, Charlie, for 69%. They've had 7 assists. They've out-rebounded IPFW 12-11. Indians are 6 of 8 from the foul line for 75%. They've only turned the ball over 5 times. IPFW started hitting some shots in the latter part of the half. They're 15 of 28 for 54%. 6 of 11 from three-point range. Terry Collins is 3 of 4 to lead that department. Again, they're 4 of 7 from the foul line. 11 rebounds, 8 turnovers. And the team has averaged 16 a game, so I guess in one way you could say they're on pace, but 8 turnovers, not all that bad. But as we wait, there's 3.5 minutes left until we start the second half. Put the coach's hat on, Charlie. You're Doug Knoll. You're at home. You're trying to defend your own turf. You're down 51-40. And really, outside of Dave Simon, who's got 12 points and 4 rebounds, Terry Collins, who's got 11 points, your other people really haven't contributed all that much. What do you tell your team in the locker room?
Well, there's no 11-point play. We don't have that in the arsenal. And speaking of, you know, arsenal, in terms of weapons, offensive weapons, we think in terms of guns and bullets. You don't like to talk in those terms in today's society. But the Dons need more weapons. We have Collins and we have Simon, and their points have come pretty precious. They've nailed some shots. Terry Collins has hit some big threes with people running at him and hands in his face. Simon has been pressured up pretty good, but we have to have some scoring. And the most likely candidate to get some scoring it's going to be Kesnitz. Jim Kesnitz has to put some points on the board. Keon Henderson certainly has the athletic ability to put some points on the board. And Bo Bauer, someone who has the basketball quite a bit, making the decisions, can also score the ball. But we have to have another score and some defensive stops and put some more pressure on the Indians, make them work a little harder than they've had to work in the first half.
Along those same lines, when you look, and we talked earlier, Simo, 9 of 13 from three-point range. You have to extend the defense and put some more pressure on the ball, but you also have to watch out if you do that for the weak side pass or the pass underneath.
And they've been getting that. They've been passing the ball to the post, and we've gotten caught watching the basketball, and then that off-the-ball cutter cuts to the basketball, and they've gotten easy baskets. You want to say give and go, but it's not really a give and go because the guy that's going is not the guy that's doing the passing to the center. So they're making the pass, and they're cutting, and they're playing some old-school basketball. They're passing the basketball, setting some screens, and moving well without the basketball. And right now, the Dons' defensive positioning and the defensive help has to be better.
Some other quick halftime numbers. Turnovers, we said IPFW with 8, Southeast Missouri with 5. SEMO has blocked 3 shots. Each team has had 4 steals. Points in the paint favor Southeast Missouri State 10-8. Points off turnovers, Indians lead 7-6. Second chance points, SEMO again leads 4-2. Again, our halftime score, Southeast Missouri State 51, IPFW 40. Mastodons will have the ball to start the second half. And I know we've talked about this on prior telecasts, Charlie. The first 5 minutes of each half, so critical. But in this case, we have to really put the clamps on defensively. Because as you said a couple of times in the first half, IPFW cannot trade baskets or it's a lost cause.
Oh, there's no question about it. And we got caught a couple of times. If you're going to trade baskets, we did get caught in a situation where we were trading our threes for their twos. And if you're going to trade baskets, I guess that's the best possible scenario. But right now, not only is this first possession important because of every game, that first few minutes of that second half is important. We're an 11-point game. The mental aspect of cutting that lead underneath the double-digit barrier and then getting a stop. And then, hey, you're in business. If you get a score, a stop, and then another score, you're right back into the thick of this basketball game.
Henderson, Kesnick, Bauer, Simon, and who am I missing? Terry Cowens on the floor for IPFW. And you've got Nelke and Griffin. Goner, Willoughby, and Wyans on the floor for SEMO. Kesnick to Simon, triple teamed. Dave tries to kick it out. Kesnick comes back with it. 18 in the shot clock, and IPFW reloads. Terry Collins, watched by Mike Nelke. He fires up a three, yes.
Great, great start. Once again, though, out of sync. Hey, but we'll take it. A three-point shot out of sync to cut the lead to 8. We'll take it, but we got to get some rhythm, offensive rhythm.
Griffin giving go to Prather, picks it out. Goner for 3, no good. Collins with the rebound. So the Dons make their first defensive stop of the second half.
Goner hadn't missed too many. I think that may have been his first miss from three-point land if that was a three-point shot.
Henderson tossed it to Collins. Unfortunately, Terry was standing on the end line, and that's a violation.
And even if he's inbounds, I don't know if you want Terry Collins with the basketball underneath the basket and literally underneath the goal.
Simon knocked the ball away for IPFW. So that's 2 defensive stops in a row. Now IPFW returns the favor almost. It'll be IPFW basketball. They're going to reset the shot clock. 18:46 left here in the second half. IPFW trails 51-43. Under 10, Charlie.
Exactly, and it's a possession. And maybe it's me, but it looks like Simon's not trying to get that extra step or a half step lower. And maybe that's the way the offense is set, but I like to see him down lower.
Simon called for a travel.
And those are wasted opportunities. We've had 2 opportunities with the basketball. And once again, turnovers when you don't get a shot. at least get a shot. You got a chance for an offensive rebound. And heck, who knows, you get a shot, it might go in.
Wyans knocks down a three. Derek Wyans now with 10 points.
And that's kind of the story, been the story of this basketball game.
Negates the Terry Collins three earlier. Bauer throws it away. Terry Collins zig. Bo Bauer thought he was going to zag. And that's now 11 turnovers on IPFW. 18-10 remaining here in the second half. 54-43 our score. Southeast Missouri State on top. Wyans, Griffin on the post. Give and go to Wyans. And he throws it off a leg.
But once again, Bo Bauer cutting to the basket with the hand in that passing lane. That's something a lot of the Dons have not been doing. It's not going with that cutter and getting a hand in the passing lane.
Mike Nelke to inbound it, the transfer from Valparaiso. Wyans, another three off the rim. Griffin with the offensive rebound. Simo reloads. Goner, who had 15 first half points. Prather with a little jumper. Norm Prather with his first points today.
On a second shot, you can't give a good basketball team more than one opportunity at the basket.
56-43 to score. Don's down by a baker's dozen. We played just over 2.5 minutes here in the second half. Collins! Count the bucket and he's fouled.
And that's a little bit home cooking right there, I'll tell you. Collins ducked his shoulder, and at best, you're probably looking at a foul on the floor, but hey, we'll take it.
Foul is going to be called, I believe, on Nelke. And for Mike Nelke, they're saying that's his fourth foul. I only had him for three in my book, but I'm not going to argue. Terry Collins misses the free throw. Golden chance missed. It's 56-45. Indians with the lead in the basketball. Willoughby. Goner. Watched by Kesnick. Wyans. Bowers hanging on to him. Goner foul line. Knocked away by Simon. Nice defensive play by Simon. Bauer to Kesnick. Kesnick off the glass and in.
Great job. That's what you need, a stop and a quick transition bucket. We haven't had much of that, and you need that. Once again, a turnover and points off turnovers.
7 points for Jim Kesnick. Turnaround jumper is good by Prather. Now Norm Prather's warming up a little bit. He's got the last 4 Indian points.
He just jumped over the Don's defense on 2 occasions.
Terry Collins with a little jump shot. Collins with 7 second half points.
Need a stop. Can't, once again, that old trading baskets.
Griffin, give and go to Willoughby. Out of bounds, they say. Last touch by Simo. It'll be IPFW basketball.
A little bit more defensive pressure, a little bit more recognition to the cutters, and that's a good adjustment by Coach Noel.
7 turnovers now by Simo. Bauer. Watched by Wyans. Kesnick, a little jumper off the rim, no good. Henderson fights for the rebound off of Willoughby. It'll be IPFW ball. And we have a timeout on the floor. 15:55 left on the second half game clock. Our score, Southeast Missouri State 58, IPFW 49. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports. Welcome back to the Coliseum, everybody. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. You get a look at the IPFW huddle, head coach Doug Knoll and his troops. Charlie, they trail by 9. They've got the deficit in single digits. They've made some nice defensive stops, but as you say, they have to continue the defensive pressure and continue to keep that deficit in single numbers.
Getting a team, making a team make adjustments and getting them out of their comfort zone. Getting any team, they've done whatever they wanted to do the first half. In this second half, they've had to work. The Indians have had to work, and the Dons are getting some hands on some passes, but they're also turning some of those baskets into their own offense. Then that way, they don't have to go through the Indian defense and that struggle that they've been going through most of the first half of being out of sync.
It'll be Mastodon ball. Bauer to inbound it. Simon forces a shot up, and he's fouled. Let's see if they're going to call Garner or Griffin. They're going to call Damon Garner with the foul. That is his first. Team second here in the second half. Dave Simon at the line to shoot two. Misses the first. Makes the second. Simon, one out of two at the stripe on that possession. It's now 58 to 50. Griffin kicks it out. 3-point shot by Garner is good. Damon Garner now has 18 points.
And once again, their threes are wide open threes because they're getting that inside action, drawing the attention of the IPFW defenders, and then they have that wide open 3-point shots.
Henderson on the wing, watched by Prather. Drives by Prather, skip pass to Collins. Collins shake and bake, off of Willoughby, shot up, no good. Simon, offensive rebound, put back, no good. Tap up and no good. Dons had three cracks at it. They say last touch by Garner. It'll be Mastodon ball, but Collins, Simon, and I'm not sure if it was Henderson or Kesnick, each had a crack at it.
I think it was Henderson, and the rim's not as kind as it was to the Indians in the first half.
Bauer looking for somebody in white. Dons, Collins, partially blocked. Simon gets it, and they're going to go jump. He went up, and I think Wyans got the ball, too, on the possession. It'll go to Southeast Missouri State.
That's a good call that time, and watching from our vantage point, I think Simon was trying to gather himself to dunk the basketball, which is going to be great for momentum. But, hey, just catch the ball, be quick enough just to get it back up. Don't bring it down.
Garner, double teamed. They kick it back out to Prather to Wyans. Wyans watched by Bauer. Griffin on the high post to Prather. Prather drives, shot up, no, but they're going to call either Collins or Simon for a foul. Terry Collins is going to be called for his first foul. He didn't believe it. First team foul here in the second half on IPFW. And at the line for Southeast Missouri State, Norm Prather. ...40% foul shooter, and he knocks the first one down. What can you say? Substitutions for IPFW, Brandon Jennings and Justin Hawkins. Second free throw coming for Prather. Knocks it down. He's got 6 points all here in the second half. It's 63-50, the lead up to 13 at 14:30 to go. Jennings, Collins to Bauer. Bow wants to drive on Wyans. Forces a shot up, it doesn't go, but Bo Bauer draws the foul and he will shoot a pair. Derek Wyans picks up his first foul. Third team foul here in the second half on Southeast Missouri State. Charlie, no clock running, so chance to cut that deficit.
Free throw is very important. Very important no matter how you get to the line, if it's a forced shot, if you can get to the line. But the big thing is to make the free throws once you get there.
Bauer makes the first, misses the second. Brandon Griffin with the rebound to Willoughby. Around the perimeter. Prather, baseline drive, and they're going to call a foul illegal pick on Garner, I believe. His third, team fourth. Garner thought he set ahead, set a good screen.
Well, maybe that's how they've been getting open all game, moving on those screens, because they sure have been open for the most part of the basketball game.
Bauer to Simon in the low post. Back up top. Collins partially blocked three shot. Griffin picks it off. It's twice now that Terry Collins has had a three-point shot partially blocked here in the second half.
Well, Terry's 6 foot, 6'1" at the most, and he takes a little time to get that shot off. And with those long, quick defenders, sometimes you're going to get that.
Willoughby, three-point shot is good. Willoughby now with two threes on the afternoon, 8 points overall.
And that one hurt. That one hurt a lot.
Hawkins around the horn to Collins. Collins being hunted by Willoughby. Pass intended for Simon, and they're going to say that Griffin pushed David Simon.
Well, if this was the NFL, that's no foul because there was a deflection, but still a push. In the NFL, once the ball is deflected, you can go for pass interference.
Three personal fouls now on Brandon Griffin. He'll take a seat on the bench, replaced by Adam Crater. IPFW inbound it. Hawkins, Simon, 18-footer off the rim, no. Garner with the rebound for Simo. They move it up the floor quickly.
Straight up. Straight up.
Wyans to Crater. Crater watched by Simon. Crater for three, no. Rebound picked off by Hawkins. Here comes Bo Bauer moving quick. Simon, triple team. Foul, bodies hit the floor, no call. Are they going to call a jump ball? And on the possession, it'll go with our stay, I should say, with IPFW. And that time, Dave Simon thought he got hammered.
Well, I thought he
illegally.
From here, it looked like he got a pretty good push in the back.
Brett Hale in the lineup, replacing Norm Prather for Southeast Missouri State. 12:44 left here in the second half. IPFW trails 66-51. Trying to snap a four-game losing streak. Collins in some trees kicks it out to Bauer. Plenty of time in the shot clock. Bounce pass, Jennings, triple team, back to Collins. Terry fake the three, penetrates, kicks it out. Jennings for three. Count the bucket, foul underneath. See who they call the foul on. They're going to call Simon for a foul underneath after the shot had been released. First foul on Simon, second on the team in the second half. Jennings got a big three there, Charlie.
Yes, very big three, and a good sign, you know, although that's a foul on Simon, probably out of frustration, but that's his first foul with almost 12 minutes to go in the second half.
Garner watched by Jennings. Willoughby, Hale, watched by the freshman Hawkins. Hale, cut off by Hawkins. Eight in the shot clock. Garner, long three ball off the rim. No, Collins fights for the rebound. Here comes the junior from Fort Wayne, Snyder, on the move. Bauer, 10-footer, short. Rebound, Garner. Bauer thought he was fouled. No call. Hale on the run. And they're going to call a reach-in foul on Hawkins, saying that he fouled Brett Hale before Hale got the pass off.
Well, there's just a sign, Mike. On the last Indian possession, Garner with the shot clock running down. No rhythm, just having to dribble and get the basketball up. If you put some pressure on him and make him do something else besides just stand still and shoot, I don't think he's going to be as effective shooter as he's been.
Timeout on the floor, 11:40 to go, 66-54 the score. Learn more about Mastodon Sports by tuning into Mastodon Spotlight each Wednesday, Friday, and Saturday here in College 56. Here's truly Mike Miles, reviews the recent sports activities. We look at game footage and visit with coaches and players. That's Mastodon Spotlight, Wednesdays at 11:30, Fridays at 6:30, and Saturdays at 11:30 a.m. right here on College 56 Sports. Well, we look at some of the numbers, Charlie. SEMO cooling down a little bit for the game now. They are 23 of 39 for 59%, 12 of 20 for 60%, 8 of 10 at the foul line for 80%. IPFW, 50% on 20 of 40 shooting from the floor, 53% of the three-point shots, 8 of 15, only 6 out of 12 free throws. I know that's a sore spot with that goal there. Rebounding advantage goes to SEMO, 19-17. And turnovers, IPFW 12, Southeast Missouri 7.
Well, you know, you say 12 to 7, but I tell you what, Mike, when you talk about those free throws, missed free throws, particularly the front end of a 1-1, is nothing much more than a turnover itself. So you already have a 12 to 7 advantage, and then you add in missed free throws. That, what we call turnover advantage, goes way up.
Lyons on the inbound pass, fires a three. Crater has a shot blocked by Simon. Picked up by Byron Malone. Good block by Dave Simon. Let's see if the Dons can convert.
Great time that time. As we have a foul there, great time, great shot block that time by Simon, keeping the basketball inbounds. Something Bill Russell used to perfect years ago with the Celtics. And we talk about shot blockers that want to knock it into the cheap seats. But to keep that basketball inbounds and give your basketball team an opportunity for a fast break.
That last foul was on Crater, his second. He's out of the lineup, replaced by Griffin. Collins on the inbounds pass, double team. He'll bring it back out. Terry with 18 points, leading IPFW in scoring. Hawkins up top, watched by Hale. Simon underneath, back out to Malone. 15 in the shot clock. Terry Collins for three, no good. Long rebound picked off by Tarek Willoughby. Here come the Indians on the run. Hale in the corner, give and go from Griffin. Shot up, and yes. Brett Hale got the lucky bounce. He now has 13 points.
Moving without the basketball, passing and then cutting hard to the basket.
We're under 11 minutes. 68-54 the score. Dons trail by a bunch. Simon, face up, turnaround jumper. No, Jennings fights for the rebound. Simon gets it. Shot up, no. Davis fouled and he'll go to the line to shoot two.
And I think the Indians, as well as most teams, are going to be willing to give David Simon that, you know, 15 to 18 foot jump shot.
Foul is on Garner. It's Dainman's fourth. Team seventh here in the second half. Simon unable to hit the first of his two free throws. Dave now 5 of 8 for the day at the line. Misses the second one as well. But he knocks the ball off Wyand's hands last, so IPFW, though they missed the two free throws, will retain possession. But again, Charlie, a chance for points lost.
It's a turnover. It's nothing, you know, once again, missed free throws are nothing more than turnovers.
Collins up top, watched by Hale. Hawkins has a size advantage if he could post up Hale. Byron Malone drifts into the land of the trees. They kick it back out. 18 in the shot clock. Hawkins and Jennings playing catch right now. 12 on the shot clock. Malone inside, kicks it out. Jennings walked with the ball, got away with it.
Wow.
And got a bucket. Christmas present for Brandon Jennings.
No kidding there.
He's got 5 points now.
Well, one thing I've noticed, Mike, our IPFW shooters have to get their feet set and ready to catch and shoot.
Willoughby caught out on low. Kick it back out. Griffin on Simon. Blocked by Jennings. Nice block by Brandon Jennings. Here comes IPFW. Malone. Jennings for three. Yes!
Just like that. Get those feet set. You can just step right into it. Step right into it. That's great timing of what I was just speaking of. Get into your shooting position. Catch the ball. Step into it. And shoot it.
The newfound offensive threat. Brandon Jennings with 8. Shot is good. Foul is called. Simon picks up his second foul. Count the bucket. Lyons, chance for the conventional 3-point play. They bucket there, makes the free throw. Derek Wyans now with 13 points. Indians have three players in double figures.
And he was a little bit out of control, and we have to make that defensive stop. He got the reward, not only hitting the basket, but getting the foul when he was out of control.
Hawkins driving, kicks it off. Jennings, who's got the hot hand. Malone, shake, bake, kick out. Hawk fakes the three. 10 and a shot clock. Jennings, gonna take it himself. Nope, steady kicks out to Malone. Three in the shot clock. Malone misses the layup. Tap up and in by Simon. First field goal of the second half by Simon. Makes it 71-61. 8.5 to go. Gunner back in playing with four fouls. Griffin. Willoughby and Griffin playing a two-man game. Turnaround jumper, no, rebounded Jennings. Boy, Brandon Jennings playing extremely well here in the second half for IPFW.
And you'll give Griffin that shot just like Simon. Let him shoot that shot.
Cowens for three, no. Jennings gets the offensive board, cross timeout. Heads up play, Brandon Jennings.
That's a very cerebral play. Great hustle and great mental play that time by Jennings.
8:03 to go, Don's Trail 71-61. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Did you know IPFW has its very own pep band? The Stomp Band is looking for more members, and we want you to join. IPFW students even receive a credit for their participation. Perfection is not required, just enthusiasm and a desire to share your school spirit. Check out our website for more information. Don't just play, stomp.
Welcome back, everybody, to the Memorial Coliseum. Again, belated Happy New Year to everybody. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. And Charlie, IPFW needed a shot in the arm, and that shot in the arm has been provided by sophomore Brandon Jennings.
Yeah, you need somebody to step up, and hustle plays are a great way to get everybody involved. When you see someone diving out of bounds, nailing a big shot, getting there and fighting for the team, it makes the rest of the players want to get in there and fight as well, and that's the way you bring a team together.
Brandon Jennings so far, 3 of 3 from the floor. 2 of those 3 are three-point shots. He's got 3 rebounds, 1 big block, and 1 foul. Not bad for the sophomore out of Canal Winchester, Ohio.
This game, Mike, is going to be won on a defensive end. If it is to be won, that's the end that it's going to be won on. But as Charles Barkley said one time when he lost the game, said, Charles, where do you think the game was lost? Well, they had more points than we had. So not only do you have to win it on a defensive end, but you also have to put the ball in the basket as well.
Jennings will inbound it. Gets it way out to Malone. Under 8 minutes now. Don's Trail 71-61. They need some offense and need to play some defense as well. Ball knocked out of bounds. They say off of Hawkins. And we have another timeout on the floor. Again, our score, Southeast Missouri State 71, IPFW 61. We'll take another break. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Do you have everything you need? Paper, pencils? We only ask that you do your best.
I made you a snack.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
Again, welcome back to the Coliseum, everybody. Mike Moss, Charlie Washington with you. Nice crowd here on a Saturday afternoon, considering the fact that, as you said earlier, Charlie, it's still a holiday weekend. School is out, and the weather, I know it's supposed to turn bad later tonight, but wasn't too cold.
Well,
earlier.
Tremendous coming in, you know, near 60 or maybe just a touch above 60, and the Dons are hanging in, hanging right there. But we just had, before this timeout, we had a hopefully not too costly a turnover right there with the game at 10. A bucket, you get under 10. And as I was stating a little earlier, the Dons, the offense, the shooters, step into those shooting pockets wherever the Indians give you on defense. Step into those shooting pockets, be ready to shoot. But right now we need a defensive stop.
Nelke with the ball for Simo. Watched by Terry Collins. Hale back to Nelke. Goner playing with four fouls. Got a big size advantage over Malone. Jumper no good. Simon with the rebound. That's Dave's 11th rebound of the afternoon. He's got a third straight double-double. 15 points and 11 boards.
Now we need to look to him inside. Look at him.
Big possession for the Dons. Malone in the trees. Cut off by Nielke. Tries to get it to Simon and throws it away. The old time turnover there. Hale looking for somebody down low. Nielke. Griffin. Skip pass to Goner. Good thing Goner's tall. Hale in the paint, back out to Wyans, three ball, short, rebound Jennings. Fourth rebound for Brandon Jennings. Dons need to score this time down to get that single digit deficit. We're nearing 6.5 minutes left in this contest. Simon, back out, Jennings for three, yes!
Great job. Great job. They're not paying him much attention, and he's stepping into that shot in rhythm. That's the key. In rhythm and looking good.
Jennings with 11 and a nice feed from Dave Simon. Griffin on Simon. Misses the shot, Simon with a 12th carom. Cowan's on the run, Terry, one on three. Cut off, ball loose. Johnny on the spot, give and go. Cowan's from Jennings. Jennings with a nice assist. And Southeast Missouri State calls timeout with the score 71-66. Mastodons cutting it to 5, Charlie.
Hey, the Dons are right there, and they're hanging in there, and hey, this is not over by any stretch.
Let's take a quick break. You're watching Mastodon basketball on College 56 Sports. At the Coliseum, 5:57 to go. It's Southeast Missouri State 71. IPFW making a charge. They have 66. Nelke with the basketball. Dons could use another defensive stop. Jennings hounding Goner. Ball out of bounds. Turnover. Simo. Pass intended for Hale. Off of his leg.
On the defensive end, that's where you get back into the basketball game. And let's get some nice looks. I'd like to see Simon touch the ball inside this time.
Bauer up top, watched by Hale to Collins on the right side. No foul called on Prather. Official's going to let him play. Bauer, 15 in the shot clock. Collins wants to do some shaking and baking. Skip past Simon inside, shot up. Yes, count him, he's fouled! That foul was on Goner, and by my count, that's 5. Oh, they're gonna call it 4. 4 fouls on Goner. Okay. Big bucket by Dave Simon, and believe it or not, Charlie, if he can make this free throw, the deficit will be cut to 2 points.
The Dons have hung around, and they can steal this one.
Free throw is good, as you can tell by the reaction of the crowd. 71-69 with 5:14 to go. Hale hounded by Malone. Nelke. Foul called underneath. Bauer picks up his second. Team fifth. Nelke to inbound it to Hale. Wyans. Nelke, they're moving on the perimeter. Goner. Covered by Jennings. Good man-to-man defense by IPFW at the moment. Griffin and Simon. Here we go. Spin left. Hale, baseline. Travel with the basketball. Turnover.
Once again, the defensive presence. Great help that time by Simon to leave his man and get over there to help. And just his presence that time caused a travel.
Doug Knoll exhorting his troops, wanting this crowd to become the sixth man. 4:42 to go. Dons looking for a tying bucket. Jennings, what a contribution he's made here today.
He has been big.
Bauer driving on Nelke. To get it around to Jennings in the corner. 12 on the shot clock. Bauer drives, spin left. Shot, force up, jump ball on the possession. It'll go to Southeast Missouri State. And that time, Bo Bauer was hoping somebody would move.
Yeah, that time he got caught just a little bit, making a freshman mistake. But for the most part, he's played a very mature basketball game.
Nelke, watched by Jennings. Hale, kick it around. Ball knocked away by Bauer off of Connor's hands, out of bounds. Ball goes over to IPFW. Now this crowd's starting to make some noise.
The Dons have been effective with David Simon up high, but I still like to see him catch the ball down low and do something with it quickly.
Byron Malone brings the ball up. Jennings looking for Collins. Now he finds Terry. Terry, this is his time. Move it around on the perimeter. Malone getting a lot of playing time here in the second half.
And
10 in the shot. I'm sorry, 10 in the shot clock. Collins shaking big. Three-pointer! No! Rebound Nelke for Simo. Three-point chance. Just didn't quite hit it. Wyans driving on Malone. Cut off by Malone. And move it back out and around. Griffin in the block. Give and go! Wyans, move it out, skip past to Nelke. Three-point shot by Nelke, no! Rebound, Bauer! Awful! Good play off of Griffin's leg, Bauer. Smart play for a freshman. And we've got a timeout on the floor. 3:10 left, it's Southeast Missouri State 71, IPFW 69. You can do more than just sit on the sidelines. Participate in the excitement of Mastodon Athletics by joining the Royal Dons Club. The Royal Dons is IPFW's official athletic booster organization. Members enjoy athletic-related special events and priority access to tickets and more. To learn about the Royal Dons Club, call 260-481-6643. Or you can write to the Royal Dons Club, 2101 East Coliseum Boulevard, Fort Wayne, Indiana, 46805. Or you can go to the IPFW Athletics website at www.ipfw.edu/athletics. Charlie, IPFW hanging tough. They are down by two. They have the basketball with 3:10 to go.
Well, this is the hump. You've fought from double digits, as many, I think it's 14 or so, and you scrapped. And now, right now, you get a bucket now, you know, you've gotten to the hump, and then you get the defensive stop and get over the hump.
Emotionally, Charlie, does IPFW have enough gas left in the tank?
Well, I think so. I think we haven't used David Simon as effectively, you know, as we could. I think the offense has done a pretty good job with him staying up in the high post. But still, Mike, I want to see him get down in the low post and force them to foul him. And or if they triple team him, as they have done down there in the post, to kick it back out and for our shooters to be ready to nail that three-point shot.
Here comes Malone over midcourt, picked up by Nelke. Bauer. Feed off of Simon's hands, out of bounds. Bauer, perhaps a little too hard in the pass. Perhaps Dave should have realized he was going to try to get the ball to him. Crucial turnover with 2:57 to go.
Nonetheless, yeah, to whatever happened there, It's the Indians basketball, and we're forced. We've been making the stops. Now we're forced. Whenever you force yourself to keep making stops without you scoring, that puts you in a hole.
Donner to Griffin. Griffin covered by Simon. Driving on Simon. Turnaround shot. No good. We're going to call a foul on Simon with the hand, not the body. Simon commits personal foul number 3. Team foul number 6.
I thought that was pretty good defense that time, you know, Mike. And that's what you want. You know, if they're going to make Griffin beat him, so be it.
Griffin only a 66% foul shooter. First free throw, good. Wow. He's hit 3 in a row. He's 3 of 5 now. The lead up to 3. Chance to make it a 2-possession game. Short, Simon with the 13th rebound. Here comes IPFW. Collins gonna be picked up by Hale. Bauer, watched by Wyans. Simo and a man-to-man. Collins, watched by Hale. Baseline drive, cut off by Hale. 10 in the shot clock. Malone, got to do some shaking and baking. Bauer inside, shot up, no, but he's fouled, and ball go to the line for 2.
Got to make these free throws this time.
Foul is on Derek Wyans, his 2nd, team 9th. Bo Bauer, the freshman from Lewis Cass High School, at the line for 2. Makes the first. Brings the Dons to within 2. Now let's see if he can make it a 1-point ball game. Good look at Doug Knoll, looking at the scoreboard. Second one good as well. Bauer 3 of 4 at the line. And Doug Knoll calls 30-second timeout. Let's take one as well. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Where can you see world-famous writers, performers, musicians, and other artists up close and personal? Right here at IPFW. On the next edition of IPFW Up Close, we'll tell you about 3 very special series that take place at IPFW every year. You'll learn all about the Omnibus, Visiting Writers, and Plugstert series. Join me, Jeanette Liu, as we learn the history of each event and how the guest artists are chosen. Watch IPFW Up Close Sundays at noon on College Cable Access Channel 56.
Welcome back to the Coliseum. Mike Maz, Charlie Washington with you. 2:09 left here on the second half scoreboard. It is Southeast Missouri State 72, IPFW 71. Indians inbound the basketball. Nelke going to be picked up by Malone. Big possession for the Indians. Nelke. Hawaiians. Hawaiians watched by Collins. Skip past Griffin underneath. Shot blocked by Simon out of bounds. Simon giving some help to Bauer.
The big fella doing it on the defensive end. Now, if he shows that kind of enthusiasm on the offensive end, the Dons can get this basketball game. I want him working hard for that basketball game, basketball on the offensive end.
Wyans underneath, off the glass and in. Bauer's going to pick up the foul. Big bucket by Simo. Wyans took it strong. For Bo Bauer, that's his 3rd foul. Wyans, left-handed shot. Good. Big 3-point play there by Wyans. Substitution, Willoughby in for Wyans. They're gonna play a little offense defense. 75-71, a minute 42 and counting. Dons trail by 4. Malone, watched by Nelke. Jennings nearly had it stolen. Malone in the trees. Bauer up top, 15 in the shot clock, minute 24 in the game clock. Dons need a score in this possession. Malone looking for somebody. Simon driving on Griffin. Shot up and in. Simon now has 20 points. It's a two-point game with 104 to go. And Southeast Missouri State calls a timeout with 103 left. You're watching Mastodon Basketball. Here in the contest, Southeast Missouri State 75, IPFW 73. 26 seconds left on the shot clock. It'll be Southeast Missouri State ball, and IPFW has just got to play some good defense, Charlie.
This has turned into, Mike, a very exciting basketball game.
Nelke to inbound it to Garner. Garner watched by Jennings. Griffin, give and go. Lions, no good. Simon with the rebound. The Collins, IPFW now with a chance to tie or maybe take a one-point lead.
We dodged the bullet right there.
And now IPFW calls a full timeout. We'll take one as well. 43 and a half seconds left. Dodge trailed by two, 75-73. You're watching IPFW basketball on College 56 Sports.
Hi. I was wondering if maybe, if you wanted to go out maybe or something, if you had time.
I can tell by your excitable behavior and verbal faux pas that you have generalized anxiety with paranoid tendencies. It would never work.
Okay, thanks.
Indiana University, Purdue University, Fort Wayne. One university, two great names.
You get a good look at the Mastodon bench. They're down two. They have the ball. 43 and a half seconds left. Charlie, what's Doug saying to the troops?
Well, I bet you he's telling we need a bucket right here, guys. I want to see Simon touch the basketball, at least create his own opportunity or suck the Indian defense in and kick it back out for maybe a three-point shot.
Well, you got a probably two-man game, Simon and Kerry Collins. Although you never know, Jennings is 2 for 2 from three-point range. 3 for 3 from three-point range, I should say. The Dons as a team, 9 of 17 for 53%. I'm sorry, 10 of 20 for 50%. The 9 of 17 at the foul line. Timeout situation. IPFW has a 30. Southeast Missouri State has a 30 and a 60. Here we go. Jennings to inbound the ball to Terry Collins.
Whatever it is, I think it needs to be going to the basket, drawing and dishing.
Collins rubs off a Jennings pick. Kicks it back out to Jennings. Around the horn to Bauer. 13 in the shot clock. Collins, 10 in the shot clock. Shake and bake time. Jennings for three. No. Simon puts the rebound up and in. We're tied. Shot clock is off.
Hold on to your hats.
And now Southeast Missouri State calls a timeout. Let's see if it's a forward or a 30. 75 off. 30-second timeout gives us a chance to remind you to tune into College 56 later tonight for the replay of this game with Southeast Missouri State. That's this evening at 7 p.m. or next Saturday, January 10th at 1 p.m. or next Sunday, January 11th at 7 p.m. Three chances to see this exciting game with Southeast Missouri State right here on College 56 Sports. Big offensive rebound on the missed three by Jennings. Dave Simon got his 15th rebound and his 22nd point.
He's had a tremendous basketball game, and I just said a moment ago that I didn't think he was touching it down low enough, but he certainly played extremely tough and doing a great job.
Okay. Oh, what a game, Charlie. And I can't wait. I got to admit, I'm going to watch the replay, be it tonight or next Saturday or next Sunday. I mean, this is exciting. The Dons trailed the entire first half. As you said, trailed by as many as 14 in the second half. Made the comeback, and now here we are tied with 16 seconds to go.
They've hung around and hung around, and I'll tell you what, Mike, they've hung around and crept into this basketball game with some unlikely heroes.
The biggest being Brandon Jennings.
Yeah, Jennings and Malone have played very steady. Now, Jennings has been outstanding, and Malone has played a very steady basketball game from the point guard position.
Each team has one 30-second timeout left. Nelke will inbound it to Hale, back to Nelke. Nelke watched by Malone. 12 seconds to go. Nelke trying to rub off a Garner pick. Now he's picked up by Jennings. Hale watched by Bauer. Spin move. 15-footer on the air. Gets the bucket with 8/10 of a second. And IPFW calls their last time out. Oh, what a shot by Southeast Missouri State. With 8/10 of a second left. Now you got one chance, one play. What do you do, Charlie?
I get it to Collins, or I look to lob it into Simon, you know, down low. But you don't have, with 8/10 of a second, you may be able to catch and shoot. But with the little home cooking, you should get a little extra moment to catch the basketball and shoot it.
Want to remind you, up ahead, Monday night, 7 o'clock, women's basketball against Morehead State. Tip off 7 p.m. here in Channel 56. And on January 17th, we start the men's volleyball season with a match being played here at the Coliseum against George Mason at 5:30. And following the volleyball game, the men's team takes on Texas A&M Corpus Christi at approximately 7:30 p.m. That's what's ahead live for IPFW Sports on Channel 56. Right now, 8/10 of a second left. And Southeast Missouri State calls their last 30-second timeout. So now both teams out of timeouts, 8/10 of a second left. The Dons have to go the length of the floor. And, well, that's probably the most relaxed person in the house, and that's official Anthony May. Again, women's basketball Monday night, 7 o'clock. Coach Bruce Patterson's gals are going to go for their second one in a row. They're going to take on Morehead State. And then Coach Arnie Ball, beginning of men's volleyball here on Channel 56 on Saturday, January 17th, 2 weeks from today, 5:30 match against George Mason. So stay tuned for that. Oh, wow, what a game. Let's see, can the Dons pull it off? We will see. Here we go, Jennings to Collins. Baseball pass, looking for Simon. Instead, it's knocked off of Griffin's hands, out of bounds, and Southeast Missouri State hangs on for the two-point win. Final score, Indian 77, Mastodon 75. What a comeback, Charlie. We just fell one shot, 2 points short.
Yeah, and this is at least the second time that this has happened to the Dons. And they play, you know, very well on this basketball court. And tremendous job by David Simon. Tremendous job by the whole basketball team hanging in there, creeping back into this basketball game. Hey, and this is a game we could have stolen away. And certainly I would have liked to seen it go into overtime at least.
Well, let's take a look at the final numbers for Southeast Missouri State. 27 of 54 from the floor for 50%. 12 of 22 from three-point range for 55%. 11 of 14 at the foul line for 79%. They were led by Damon Garner with 18 points. Derek Winans with 16. Brett Hale with 15, including the game winner with 8/10 of a second left. Other scoring, Griffin with 9. Willoughby with 8. Prather with 6, Nelke with 3, Hence with 2. Crater played but did not score. For IPFW, 28 of 54 from the floor for 52%, 10 of 21 from three-point range for 48%, 9 of 17 at the foul line for 53%. They were led by Dave Simon with 22 points, also 15 rebounds. Terry Collins had 20 points. Sophomore Brandon Jennings, 11 points. Big effort from Brandon. He had 4 rebounds and a block. They're the only Dons in double figures. 7 points apiece from Bo Bauer and Jim Kesnick. 5 points from Keon Henderson. 3 points from Kyle Thrasher. Playing but not scoring, Justin Hawkins and Byron Malone. Rebounding advantage goes to IPFW, 30-23. Turnovers, IPFW 16, SEMO 10. Blocks, 5 apiece. Steals, 5 apiece. Points in the paint, 20-16 in favor of the Mastodons. Points off turnovers, 15-10 in favor of the Indians. Second chance points favored Southeast Missouri, 9-8. Charlie, the Dons played a heck of a second half. They just fell 2 points short. They dropped to 2-11 overall, 2-3 at home. Southeast Missouri State improves to 7-4 overall. They won their first road game in 6 tries. And it was a very, very good second half of basketball.
And there's no question about that. And Coach Doug Noe and his coaching staff need an awful lot of credit for making the adjustments. Basketball is all about adjustments. And in that first half, the Indians did whatever they wanted to do, got whatever shot they wanted to, and they were nailing them. Great adjustment by Doug Noe and his staff once again to make it tough. And also, we certainly have to give the players credit for executing that game plan in the second half.
Okay, Charlie, up next for the Mastodon men's program, they're going to go on the road for 3 games. They're going to play at Middle Tennessee State on Tuesday night. They're going to travel to Colorado Springs, Colorado for the Air Force Academy. I believe it's on Saturday, a week from today. And then on the 14th, they're going to be up in Kalamazoo to play against the Broncos of Western Michigan. You and I will get together again on the 17th, 2 weeks from tonight, when Texas A&M Corpus Christi comes to town. So we will see you in 2 weeks.
All righty, sir. I'll be looking forward to it.
At this time, we'd like to thank the College 56 production crew, the IPFW athletic staff, the city of Fort Wayne, Comcast Cablevision, the IPFW Learning Resource Center, and especially the IPFW Office of University Relations and Communications for their contributions to this College 56 sports telecast. This telecast of IPFW Sports is copyrighted and the sole property of the College Cable Access Center and IPFW. Unauthorized duplication, exhibition, rebroadcast, retransmission, or other use of this event without expressed written consent is strictly prohibited. We hope you've enjoyed this telecast of IPFW Sports, if not the outcome, and we thank you for joining us again today. For Charlie Washington, this is Mike Moss saying so long for now. Once again, our final score, Southeast Missouri State 77, IPFW 75. Until the replay tonight at 7 o'clock or Monday night live at 7 for the women's game against Morehead State, we wish you a very pleasant good afternoon from the Memorial Coliseum here in Fort Wayne, Indiana.